Moving on with this piece, this biface, I'm gonna work this face down further, get rid of this high spot first, and flip it around and get rid of the rest of this cortex and try and thin it down real nice. Make a hafted knife or something. This fan is really loud over here. I want to turn it off, but I really need to have it on in here for ventilation, so that's just the way it is right now. I was working on this other thing, trying out some Aldoan technology on this. Not exactly sure what type of stone that is. Anyways, doing some hammer and anvil type work. You know, this is some of the earliest stone tools. These are some of the flakes I got off at first. And then it was mostly smaller ones after that. I was using this as the anvil and using that as the hammer and just striking this and knocking off flakes. Really testing out a different technology that I've never really done before, so that was interesting. I'm gonna do a little bit of hammerstone work on this, but mostly it'll be antler from here on in and small hammer stones for setting up platforms. Guess I'm using more hammerstone than I originally intended, but it's working pretty well right now. knew I didn't have that platform set up properly, but I went for it anyways. pretty brutal. I've got a lot of thinning to do down here. Come at it from this angle. That'll work properly, but here goes nothing. Nice. Got a whole bunch of that part thinned down. Still got a ways to go to fix that up, but it's looking better at least. That was awesome. Went better than I expected. Well, this is not going great. I'm gonna switch to the antler, I think. This is getting pretty beat up. I've been using it a lot. This was rounded before. I used this face to strike. And I'm kind of moving it around. I'm using up here right now, like this. I used to have to set up my next platform with hammerstone all the time when I was doing antler work, but I kind of learned more recently to just set them up with the antler itself, you know, take off small ones like this. Never really felt comfortable with it before. It does eat up the material faster here. That's probably why it looks like this now, but you know, I'll find more antler like this in the future. It's faster and it's more efficient actually. Setting up platforms with the material, you know, the same type of tool material that you're taking the big flake with is definitely an added bonus. It kind of, you know, sets up the angles a little bit more appropriately, and you can kind of, that was a nice one, you can kind of feel when the platform is, you know, strong enough to take the good flake, the big one, you know, you kind of brush it like this. Hopefully that was all in camera. In focus, you kind of brush it like this, which I think is a flint knapping tips term, brushing. Then, you know, you just take those micro flakes . Set up those platforms just right, and then take the bigger flake . Probably cut this video now. Don't know how long it got to. The time is covered up on my phone screen by the holder that it's in. So it's probably been about 20 minutes by this point, which is about how long I like to keep my videos. Nice. Well, it's getting a little better. That's enough for now. I made a lot of good progress on this, actually. It's looking much better than I was thinking it was gonna look by this stage. I should probably move down to indirect percussion now to take a series of nice, you know, as parallel as possible, thinning flakes on both faces. And then I'll do some retouching. Pressure flaking. I don't know if I'll notch it, but I'll end up making a handle and hafting it at some point. Hopefully I can get that done fairly soon. Okay, moving on to the next step.